It's July the 31st, 2014. You are listening to the Nuclear Proctologists. You can find my site at thenuclearproctologist.org. Hang on a second. Oops, I remembered everything but that. Double check, make sure I'm screaming. Check over here on the computer. My computer, anytime you're ready. We got a good show tonight. Connecting Dots 2 is upset. And I'm not sure how to explain it, so we're going to do a video. I'm just waiting for my video to show up over here to make sure I am streaming. Good night, everybody. Broken Ass. Hang on, check the audio. It's going to pop up any second.
Hang on a sec.
There you go. We're good to go. Now, allegedly, according to the officials, this is Building 4, the interior you're looking at. And that might seem confusing to some people, like myself. Because I want you to imagine that building is inside of this building. Right? And now we know that I have done this story over and over and over and over until infinity. And I have told everybody nightly, they bring big pieces and they pick it up with a crane and they install it, right? And then they get another piece and they put it on top of that and they keep going. And then they're going to extend over the building. I covered this so much, I'm so sick of saying it. And now I want you to think about the building behind me. They're not working on that building, they're working on the structure. And so the pool over here is not, what I'm saying is not inside this building. And it's not inside that structure. The fuel pool you're looking at is what, that's an official picture from TEPCO, and they're claiming that that fuel pool you see there is inside of this building. And Connecting the Dots is saying that this structure right here is what I'm missing. And I cover it every friggin' night for 9 months that they put this fake structure in there. And let me keep going and explain it to you. Right, so they're gonna build a structure alongside of it, and the structure goes up, you can see. It's just cranes lifting it in and laying it there. And we're gonna cover everything on this tonight just to finally clear it up. Now there's a link under my video to nuclearproctologist.org. Go over to the right hand side. Hang on, I'll do that for you right now. And so you come over, oh, hang on, I gotta click onto that before that works. So you come over to the nuclearproctologist.org, you go up to the sections, and you click on sections, I forgot to make my chummy, and then you scroll down till you see page 12, unit 4. You click that, and because it's the cloud, give it a second, and it'll start loading up. And so there's roughly 500 pieces of information below. And you can find, go through all of that yourself. And I'm going to add about another 100 on there tonight. The pictures I uploaded never all showed up. You can see down here these pictures. And not all of them have showed up. So I'll go ahead and finish that job tonight after the show. And let me come back over. That gets confusing looking. Hey! That's okay. So the building behind me, inside of it, Connecting the Dots claims the fuel pools are, and that the walls are these structures. And the walls we see there are somehow these structures, is what he's saying. And so that's pretty ludicrous. Here's another look at it. Like, you can see the building behind me has nothing to do with that building there. The building on the top that they built does not have this fuel pool in it. That's what we're talking about. The fuel pool we're talking about is inside of Unit 4 structure itself, right? It's inside this unit. Now, they didn't repair the pool, right? They didn't take the pool and turn it into Molly Maid by putting a structure around it, right? You see that structure? That's got nothing to do with that building. It doesn't actually physically touch the building. That's according to TEPCO themselves. It's not supporting, it's not meant to support that building at all. The story is they're going to put a crane eventually in that. They don't have a crane in it yet, but they're eventually going to put a crane in it, and they're going to try to reach into this building here, right? And apparently inside of this building is this thing, and they're going to pull the rods out. So you can't have two of it. You can't build this and then claim that it's inside of that, that new structure. It doesn't work that way. The reactor melted down. I cover this all the time, that they lay in these pieces, and it's got nothing to do with the fuel pool. The fuel pool is fake. That fuel pool is not real. That's nowhere near real. CBC had it, BBC put it up there, RT. I covered all that in my last two videos. Verbatim. Okay? You can't get from here to this thing here by putting a bunch of bricks together and end up with a fuel pool on the inside. I don't know what to say to somebody that can't work that out in their mind, or maybe if they don't want to work it out in their mind, maybe they got something invested in it. I got no idea, but I got a doozy for you, and I might have to turn off. Hang on a second. So how can you get above me, right? How do you get there to that there? How does that happen? Just think about that for 1 second. I'm just going to turn off me on the other one. And that didn't work out the way I wanted it. Hang on, I can't do that. I hear stuttering going on, I don't know why. That's okay. And so let's hope this works for us. Here's a clip. I hope it's the one anyway. Let me double check. Yeah, this is a video that he connecting the dot put up. I'm stuttering on my end. Is the audio okay? Because I'm really stuttering bad here. I shouldn't be doing that. So let's play that video. So he put a whole bunch of pump music to it, and he's claiming it's the interior by doing that, right? So here we go.
Only reason why this structure was built. They are not rebuilding reactor 4. It's done. Once the spent fuel's out of there, it's going to be decommissioned. Guaranteed. Okay, now, the big wake-up call, Dana. Take a look here. You see how these columns are all painted gray? Look in the background here. This is all gray. This is that prefab structure I was telling you about. Okay? No, pay attention here.
I got problems with my audio. Hang on. I don't know what that's all about. How did that happen? I'm going to have to shut down and pop back. UN official. I'm going to close down the other page. Just hang on a second, because that's not normal. You get that popping. Are you getting it on your end, folks? Missing a few dots, most likely. I don't know why I'm getting all this pounding going on. Hang on. Sorry. Dana, the audio is good. Amter says, audio is good. Stuttering, but not too bad. Shouldn't be stuttering. Okay, hang on. I'm going to disappear. I'm going to disappear. Hang on. Let me get rid of that. Get rid of that. Get rid of that. I'm being hacked, I think. Hang on. Let me get rid of that. Let me save that. Okay, I'll be back in a minute, folks. That seems better. Body still choppy. Shouldn't be choppy. So it's coming in choppy again. Hang on. And that's just the way, it's pretty rare for this to happen, so hey, bear with me, folks. I'll get rid of this. Okay. I'm gonna do that one more time now. Hang on. Well, that was a pain in the ass. Well, that's a pain in the ass. Is that still popping? Hi, everybody. Yeah, it's still popping. I don't know what to do. That's not normal. No, that's not normal. This is all new gear. We've been doing this each night. That's all this gets used for. This was working fine when I started, right? So, I wouldn't doubt if they're hacking the shit out of me. Yeah, that's too bad. We dropped off. So is my... So that shouldn't be doing that, right? Okay, I'm gonna restart the computer. I'll be right back. 2 minutes. Go have a break, folks. Get a glass of water. Sorry. Well, I don't know what to do. Everything's screwed up on my end. It's heartbreaking. It's heartbreaking. We'll probably call it a night. Much I can do. So I'm being hacked as far as I'm concerned. You can't have that building inside of the other one, right? You only built the shelter over the building. You didn't build a new one inside of it. That's the story. That's why they're hacking me. That's why I'm having all these issues tonight. I've been doing this for 9 months. This is new equipment. 2 weeks perfect. Never done nothing different. And this computer can definitely handle it. An 8-core computer. This piece of cake. And so they're on me. Which is to be expected because we just blew a hole in them, right? We just popped a bubble. There's no way one can be the same as the other. You can't have this one behind me and not rebuild it and show us that picture. It doesn't work that way. Putting a structure alongside of it is not going to change that. Building it higher is not going to change it. And building over it is not going to change it. And so the audio is really bad. Audio is too bad. Yeah, it might be good on your end, folks. Dan is back. He's moved. Kate says she got great graphics and audio. Amter says there's an echo. You must have two going. Dan is still an echo. Stuttering sounds better. Seems okay. Well, I'll just finish up for the next few minutes. I'm going to give it up. I got to check my computer because that's not good. Look, they never changed the interior of that building. Okay? They didn't change the interior of the building, so how could they get to there? You can't get to there by building a structure alongside of it and a structure over it. You don't have to be a genius to work that out. You got to think about who's doing the job, okay? The homeless people are being sold to companies and put to work at the Fukushima radiation. You know, the homeless are taking the work in Fukushima ready to die. At the end of the month, they got no money and they end up in debt. You're probably hearing an echo. I'm through some my end from my headphones because I'm having a hard time with this tonight and that's not normal. Mentally disabled working at Fukushima Daiichi. Homeless treated like disposable. And they're supposed to be the ones who came in and fixed it all. Please. Since when can mentally disabled pull off that one? Right? You know, there's a cynical disregard for human life. There's no other way to put this. Mentally handicapped working at Fukushima plant after the meltdown. And we're supposed to believe that this is the accumulation of all of that. And that we ended up with that interior just by putting a lid on it. By building a building alongside of it. All of a sudden the fuel pool is hunky friggin' dory. That we went from there to there, rather from here to over to there. By using homeless people. How come they didn't do it at Chernobyl? Chernobyl one-third the size. 30% meltdown. Don't forget that Fukushima's 3,450 assemblies in each pool. There's more than one pool at Unit 4. It wasn't just a single. They took the shit out of the reactor and put it in a pool and that's all it was there. It's not like what they're saying, oh, it's all right here in the pool, Dana. It's ludicrous for someone to come out and do that to me and suggest that to me, come up and berate me and try to marginalize everybody else, including the hounds of Fukushima, who are just saying the homeless are taking the work in Fukushima ready to die because they don't know any better. They're going inside of that building, and there's no way that they turn around and turn it into that. The homeless can't read, they can't write, they're mentally retarded, they're mentally challenged, bless their little hearts. These are the homeless. They're given paper suits. There's people on top of that building, but they have a lead shield and then a titanium shield. And then they have paper suits, so they don't drop dead up there and scare the shit out of everybody. I've been hacked tonight. I got hacked as far as I'm concerned. But you can't turn around and put homeless people there and end up with that, and there's not no documentary on it. How come they didn't do that? Unit 1 didn't blow up half as bad. They're building a Kevlar sarcophagus around it. Right? They lift up the panels and they lay the panels into place. They don't have someone up there with a wrench tighten it up. I cover that every night. Every night. That's all they're doing. Look. They built a frame around it. And then they lift it up with cranes and put the panels on it. I cover that every night, and he's over there connecting dots too, saying, I don't know what the fuck that means, that I don't cover that, that I missed that, that somehow by doing that, the fuel pools fixed themselves, the buildings are fine. He's telling me in his recordings that I can't play tonight that by building a structure up and across it, somehow or another, that resolved the issue. It's stupid. The building detonated. Right? And I can't argue with people like that because they won't look at this side of it, that all they done was built a structure. They built a structure alongside of it, across it. It doesn't touch it. Here's another picture. We'll call it a night. The sound is okay. Okay, we'll keep going for a few extra minutes. But look, I mean, the building doesn't touch it. They didn't build a new structure inside of it. They didn't put a fuel pool like that inside of it. Right? They didn't magically do that. They just built a structure alongside of it and over the top of it. Do you see a crane in that structure? Do you see this crane in that structure? Do you see that fuel pool? They didn't put a fuel pool in the structure. The fuel pool is on the ground. Have a look at where the people are standing. The people are standing alongside of it. Look, here's Seth Dorn. Is it Seth Dorn? Where's he to? Now he's saying he's in alongside the fuel pool. But how can you, there's no, the homeless didn't go in there and build that. I got no audio or what? I turned it down. Now let's try Seth. Here's Seth. Play Seth. He's not going to play. Well, he's saying from CBS that he's inside Unit 4. Right? That's what he's saying. He's inside Unit 4. And he's not going to play. Great. And all he done was built a structure alongside of it. That's all he done. I covered this over and over every bloody time. Just like bananas. I cover it over and over and over. It's got nothing to do with man-made radioactive material. And that fuel pool did not get built. That's what I'm saying. What's so hard about that? I'm actually going to chop this video after and poke it back out because so much carnage. Hi, Luna. Look, after first explosion, only a matter of time for the nuclear fuel would melt into the open. Okay, hang on. Here we go. I got to open up. Hang on, open up a browser. I'll hang out. We can get everything to work. That's awesome. That's pretty sad, though, that everything screwed up as bad as it did. Here we go. Okay, we're going to go over to the nuclear proctologist where I posted a new section on Unit 4. And scroll down a little bit and click on it and it'll jump. Give it a second and it'll load up. Now at the bottom of the page will be the other sections. But you'll see all this writing at the top. You can read through that on your own. And the first sections is the homeless. And you just double click any one of those and you get a full page. And after the first explosion, only a matter of time for nuclear fuel. That's where I just left out. Homeless are taken to work in Fukushima. We done that. Here's how thick those walls are. They were destroyed, right? Worse than a meltdown, says expert. Spent nuclear fuel catches fire. And got radiation levels too high in Unit 4. And workers forced to cover the floor with lead. Right, that's how they got on the roof of it. They were, right, they covered the floor with lead. And they sent the homeless and the mentally retarded people who can't read and write up on the roof. And TEPCO requests media not film Unit 4 operation, checking if fuel was affected by Unit 3 explosion, and blah, 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 July the 18th, 2012. But TEPCO releases badly altered images of Fukushima Unit 4. They faked the pictures. TEPCO edited Photoshop images and removed original alterations, September the 4th, 2012. TEPCO, we fabricated part of the photos. Why? Why do you think they done that? So it didn't jump around, we didn't get the other windows? Oh, I'm sorry. What the hell, eh? Didn't work? According to what I'm seeing there, it didn't work, so. And so my video over there should be showing you the desktop, and it's not showing us the desk. Didn't show us the desktop. I don't know what to do with it. Let me get rid of that and see if it shows up now. Is having that on the desktop any different? Yeah, the core is still going down, Harry. The core is going down. It's not coming back. And I was supposed to get the desktop presenter at the nuclear proctologist, and it didn't show up. And I'm just going to wait and see if it shows up on the other screen. I'm like, I got a 40-second delay. And so we'll just hang on a second and let that play out. Because if not, I'll jump back over to the other screen. So everything is really weird tonight. We got the bucking in the ears. We have my videos won't play. And now I got nothing on my screen. I'm there yakking away and I got nothing on my screen. And here, that's where I think I figured it out. And so I got rid of the screen. Hang on, folks. Hang on, we're rocking through. So what difference does it make anyway if they're removing the fuel at a Unit 4, which they're not, right? If you go over to my site at thenuclearproctologist.org and go over to the right-hand side sections, that's missing out of the screen capture tonight. Freaking going to torture me. Let's come back over to the desktop. That didn't work out the way it's supposed to. I don't know what to make of it. So the building behind me is built up and over it, and Unit 4 is below it. And inside of Unit 4, this does not exist. But Connecting the Dot had put out video 6 months ago of the interior, saying they're removing the fuel. And so he bought into the Fuji Kool-Aid. And that's okay, right? But don't take it out on me because I'm showing the facts. Because that building that they built over got nothing to do with the interior of it. They didn't fix the interior of it. Right, and that's why they hacked me earlier, and that's why they got lost. Well, there's four cores, you know, the three or four fuel pools that were in Unit 4 and were detonated. They caught fire, they melted, liquefied, melted down too. All three reactors liquefied. We've never seen one liquefy ever, all three at Fukushima, because they were using missiles from silos. That's been sitting in silos for decades, nuclear missiles, and then put them through the chain reaction again. And so they all had at least 1,000 pounds of plutonium into it. And if you know anything about that, you know how long it takes to make that stuff. Once again, hang on, boys. They never rebuilt the inside of the reactor. This is not part, what you're seeing here now is not part of the structure that they built up. It's just tubes where they dropped it in with the big cranes, right? And they dropped piece after piece in, and they built it all the way up. And then when they built it up, they started to come across it. And then you can see this view right here, right? There's nothing in there. There's no structure there to hold or to build anything. They haven't done anything to it is what I'm trying to say to you. And they certainly didn't do anything inside the reactor. They didn't replace it with a new fuel pool and new cranes. They're going to put a crane at some point in the building over it. But inside, right across from me, inside of Unit 4, that's what we're talking about. The fuel pool is inside of that building. Inside of that building. It's not in this building. This is a new building that they use the cranes to build. I don't know how many times I can say this. I've been doing it for 9 months, saying the same thing over and over. And somebody named Connecting Dots 2 has made 2 videos saying that I don't know what I'm talking about, because that makes sense to him, that inside of that structure somewhere are the fuel pools. It doesn't make sense. And he's saying that because the homeless were sent in there and got their picture taken, the mentally handicapped, who are like, hey, this is cool, we're getting our picture taken. Yay! The people back at the mental institution will be so happy. Fukushima has a cynical disregard for life. And TEPCO has a shortage of workers. They're running out of workers. Homeless are taking the work in Fukushima, ready to die because they know they're going to hell there. They're being sold to companies and put to work at the Fukushima radiation, because real scientists around the world can't even come in there and do that. They can't come in and build a new pool. Nobody can build a new pool. You can't have a new pool but building a building alongside of it and across it and end up with a new pool inside of it, shaking a bunch of chicken bones and rocking it out, cutting the chicken's throat and dancing around the campfire. Still ain't going to make it happen. You still can't do it. You're still not going to end up with a brand new, Molly made, beautiful fuel pool. No matter how hard you try, no matter how much you wish, if everybody in the world was to hold hands and wish that this building would magically repair itself, even, you know, I don't know what to say to somebody that tells me that building a structure alongside of it and then creeping out over the top of it, not touching the buildings, somehow solved everybody's problem, and all you got to do now is inside of the building, everything was perfect. And he actually says the entire building didn't blow apart. Right? He actually says that. The building did not blow apart in his last video that he put out today. That's pretty funny. No, I mean, those people there, I get it, you know, they got lead lining on the floor, and then they got titanium on top of that, and then they send the most vulnerable of society in to walk around, get some pictures. And then people naturally think that building a structure alongside of it solved all of our problems. Everything is good. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah, look at that, boy. That structure fixed the pool at the same time. And all he done was lift in the crane pieces and dropped them there. So if you're lifting crane pieces in and you're dropping on an existing destroyed reactor like the one above me, how did it end up like the one across from me? How did the homeless and the mentally handicapped work that one out when even the best engineers on the planet would cost a fortune to go in and repair it and put it in that shape? But according to Connecting Dots, it's worth coming out and attacking everybody, making everybody miserable by saying that I'm making everything up and that the fuel pool is perfectly normal, seeing as they built a structure alongside of it and over it. Because that makes sense to somebody on the planet, and they happen to have a camera and a YouTube account, and I gotta come here and scream till my voice is raw. Not really. That I cover it every fucking night. I don't know what you want me to do, man. I think you're a shill. I don't think you could be that stupid. I don't think anybody could be that stupid to look at and say, hey, they built a structure up, a structure across. So inside of it, nothing has changed because they still haven't even found Chernobyl's core, corium 25 years later. How come they don't go down to Chernobyl and build a new fuel pool? How come there's no documentaries? It's ludicrous because that building had more than one fuel pool. It wasn't just one. They're all missing. They all blew up. They're all destroyed. I don't know if you realize it or not, but the building blew up. Everything about it blew up. You see those rails alongside of me, those beams, You can put a great big SUV on that and back it and go forward and back it and actually turn it around. So how much carnage? And you see that picture, buddy? Remember the other picture? I forgot, you know. And when I was putting it in there, I meant to grab it. There's another picture with another guy right alongside of that. It doesn't look like a guy. It looks like a guy got melted or something. And so the Fukushima 50 ran through that place, and they get some pictures, and everything is hunky-dory, Dana. See, Dana, we killed a couple of homeless, but now we can bludgeon you with a few pictures and say that building alongside of an over somehow magically equated to a brand new fuel pool inside the smashed up, destroyed, annihilated structure. I don't know what to say to you, only you're batshit crazy. You are whack job material. You need to get some medication, big time. Like Valium, and take lots of them. There is no fucking hope for someone like you. But for the rest of the world, you can go to the nuclearproctologist.org and don't scream, Dana, because I can't, like, I get everybody saying, Dana, sit up and cheer. Dana, put your shoulder back, chest out, stomach in, chin up. Don't curse, don't yell, don't swear, don't talk, don't walk, don't move your arms around. Center yourself in front of that camera. Get your best profile. Get that fucking mic out of the way. Eat some supper before you come out here. Don't drink water, you slurp, your teeth. I'm not yelling at you, I'm yelling at everybody out there. I'm not yelling at them, I'm just saying, if I could do what everybody wanted to do, I'd be, this is Fox News. Welcome to the fluff nonsense. I'm just me. Sometimes I yell. I don't even know I'm yelling. I don't even know what my name is when I wake up in the morning, because people are telling me inside of one structure is another structure, and I'm so tired. I'm so tired of telling people this story that today I went out and got 537 additional pieces of information, and I was so friggin' tired I couldn't even do a proper video tonight. And I got shit on earlier because I don't know what to do, you know. You can't have build a structure up and then across it and then inside of it end up with something like that. No, it doesn't work that way. It really doesn't. I don't want to be saying this. Look, they built a structure. They didn't go inside a unit. For fuel pool, we wouldn't be sitting here having this conversation. Ah. I don't have to say to anybody anymore. You build a structure alongside of a crane, and all of a sudden the fuel pool's fine, Dana. You're a loony, Dana. It's all fine. Right? They never went inside and took this, what's above behind me, and turned it into that. No, that's not what the argument is. The argument is they built a structure up and across, and inside of it, it magically worked itself out, and everything is now hunky-dory. Have a nice day, Dana. Leave everybody alone. Just walk away, Dana. Look at the buildings. They blew up. But boom! Do you think, for 1 second, that inside of these two buildings is this creature? If you do, I can't help you. Nobody can. You're beyond reproach anymore. You can't build a structure up and across it, put a little cap on it, they don't touch each other, get some pictures of the homeless. Right? Get some pictures of the homeless. I'll get it to once. Get some pictures of the mentally disabled. Go into this place here. And then pop pictures out on the internet saying, yeah, we built a structure alongside of it, now everything is good. Because we're magic people. We got some chicken bones, shook them up. And we got some sacrificial homeless people. And then the gods came down and fixed it. That's what I was. Whoa, baby. Radiation forecast in Japan kept secret to avoid panic in the whole of society. See, this was another one he attacked me on. Then he said, oh, don't matter. He came out and tried to murder me over it. And it's not going to show up there tonight. Hang on. I fixed that. I'll fix that. Give me a second. Because that's not what's supposed to happen. Hang on, folks. It's gonna look stupid, but hey, whatever. 5,000. I'm gonna point there with four hands. 5,000. See, I'm mutated. I got four hands. But roughly 5,000 estimates of how the radiation dispersal around Japan were kept secret. They were kept secret. Right? They were kept secret. And then they came out with a fable and said, don't worry about Unit 1. Don't worry about Unit 2. Don't worry about 3 with the max fuel. Worry about Unit 4, right? And oh, by the way, go to the rescue, builds a shelter, extends it over, it magically gets a pull on the inside, and then the media all pokes that picture out and says, grave times at Fukushima. Workers are attempting to remove fuel pools from the dangerous fuel pull rod pools, blah, blah, blah. Right? So it's a big fable, see? And it sucks everybody in. Everybody holds their breath. And a couple of years go by, and TEPCO announces they got all the fuel rods out. Meanwhile, all they got was a belly went up and across it, and there's nothing on the inside of it. They just keep pumping out the picture, pumping out the picture, and all the media get the bloggers like Connect Dots Dot number 3 come out and attack people like me who tell you different, who give you the real narrative, who show you the actual picture, who have a site set up, nuclearproctologist.org, so you can go there and learn about the subjects. And because of the last 5 and 6 days, I just got back to that site today, and I'm going to upload the Nuclear Earth series onto that site. Tonight I'm going to put more pictures up, and some of the, I tried the Nuclear series, it didn't show up, so I'll do it again. And I uploaded the pictures twice today, they didn't show up, so I got to do that again. And that's just the price you pay sometimes for new sites, I guess. But inside of that reactor is not inside of Unit 4. Right? That reactor is not inside a Unit 4, and building a structure alongside of it and over it and pinning it in is not going to change that. Right? It's not going to make anything difference. The building is utterly destroyed. You can't get inside the reactors. They would have done Chernobyl 1, 2, and 3. Four and all this other stuff would have been done a very long time ago. Hi, Miss Milky. Hi, Jen. And hugs for Jen. She's suffering. I understand the drama and the headaches and everything else. But when you look at the one over my head, they built a structure up. There's Unit 4. They didn't go inside that work. Look alongside of me. That is not inside of that Reactor 4. These people are not standing on the floor of Reactor 4. These are not in the same square mile. That's most likely the Daini plant that they're showing you there. That's definitely not Fukushima. And if you go to nuclearproctologist.org, it won't take you too long to figure that out, right? And make sure you understand that homeless people can't perform miracles at Fukushima. The nuclear scientists all over the planet couldn't go in there and put Humpty together again. It just doesn't work that way. Well, folks, you know, that was a screwed up stream tonight. My apologies. I don't know what happened. I'm assuming I got hacked. And because there's no reason, I got extraordinary. I got my computer so powerful I could be streaming 5 people and streaming out 1280 by 720 and it still wouldn't affect my computer. There was no reason for that jumping in the audio. I don't use this computer for nothing but streaming. And I only go online when I'm ready to stream with it. And so, and I've been at this for many years. It's not like I'm naive, okay? There's nothing extra on the computer. There's no bad files ingested into the computer. You know, I create everything myself to make sure I got the right format for everything I'm doing. I'm meticulous and methodical on what I do. And so if you go to nuclearproctologist.org, you'll find in the sections to the right-hand side, Unit 4, and there will be close to 500 articles and pictures there. You can make up your own mind, and you can actually really appreciate what I'm trying to tell you. I couldn't possibly cover that, and none of it did I cover tonight, only just the very basics. So everything is sitting there for everybody at their leisure to take their time and read through it. Miss Milky got a rebuttal in for her copyrights. Poor girl, she's been hammered. I haven't stopped, just like everybody else. We're all in this together, or we all hang separate, right? Connecting the dot, she come out with a retraction and say, you know, Dana, right, there's no way you can get this perfect building just because you built a structure above it and across from it, and that causing these conflicts and fighting and arguing and insinuating without representation by just coming out with your own ad hominem versions is not conducive of coming to solutions and coming to terms. We can't have a solution until we admit there's an issue. And the issue is inside of the structure, right? Inside of that building that was detonated. This does not exist. It does not exist, right? Inside of that detonation was this. This is what looks like Unit 4. You can't get from there by putting a structure alongside of and over it and putting, you know, edging around the side of it. The buildings are not touching each other, and end up with this on the inside. It doesn't work that way. All the scientists on the planet cannot put Fukushima back together again. That's why they built that structure and the one over it. If they could build a new pool like that, they wouldn't need the structure. Right. I can only say it so many ways. Good night, everybody. I got the stream out. Thanks, Adam, Luna, Miss Frill, France, Annabek, Stacy. Hey, Stacy, I really love your little nuclear proctologist pictures. I meant to import them tonight just to show off to everybody. I'll have to remember to do that the next time. I got screen captures. That was pretty cute. That was actually really, really nice. That was good thinking. The way you done it, I really learned a lot just looking at that. And you can learn a lot too by looking at the actual evidence and saying they built a structure up and across, but they never built nothing on the inside. Nothing has changed. The building is still destroyed. And how can you have the ceilings and the walls? It's just not possible. I wish he was right connecting the dots too. I wish I was crazy and I didn't know what I was talking about. I really truly do. Right? The only reason I'm here for 9 months, besides the fact Miss Milky woke me up, is it woke me up that I had to cover this religiously. This is more important than everything put together. I understood that, but there was something missing. I don't know what it was, but I do know Miss Milky definitely helped me understand the difference. And, you know, she's been at this since day one. And I understood, you know, long story short was I understood nuclear in weapons. I didn't understand nuclear accidents. And I had a lot on it, but I didn't comprehend that radiation, you know, coming from Fukushima was going to do what it was going to do till I discovered that. And then I haven't stopped. I got up to speed and I haven't stopped since then, right? Just once again, remember, Japan hid 5,000 studies, right? They hid the 5,000 studies that were paid for by the taxpayers so they would know what to do, and they hid them so they couldn't know what to do. And then they faked the building alongside of me. Let's see if I got a better picture for you. They faked that, right? And they built up and across and over the top of it, but they didn't go inside of and create that. And so, like, I'm done saying this. There's a section up on my site. Lots of bugs tonight. Good night, everybody. Thank you, Amthurst. Hugs for you, too. You know, I'm not yelling at you, right? I just took advantage of it. I know you wouldn't take offense to it. For goodness sakes, never do that, anybody. Stephen Meyer. Stacy, you're welcome, Stacy. Yeah, okay. Yeah, send them to Dana Durnford at hotmail.com. Hi, Mickey. That'd be awesome, Stacy. High quality. You kidding me? I appreciate that so much. I really enjoyed seeing that picture. I was just smiling when I seen it because it just gives me an ideas, right, of things I got to get done. It made my mind expand. Alex, Amthurst, that's right. Miss Milky, we love her. Steven, nothing's going to change that. She walks right now. It's irrelevant in the sense of we'll still love her. There's nothing going to change that, I can assure you. She already done her work. No one can blame anybody. for giving it all up, right? So once again, you built the structure up and across it, right? Up and across. And then underneath it, nothing's changed. And the building over here is not real. That's not real. And all the mainstream media put that up there. And that's in the fabrication. So you don't think about 1, 2, 3. You don't think about all the homeless, the mentally retarded, that they're murdering at a phenomenal rate where they're running out of them. And scientists, Kim Buesler, Jay McCullen from the University of Victoria, they're not going to go down there. Jay Collin or Kim Buesler from Woods Hole Oceanographic is going around telling everybody around the world for 3 years that it's like bananas. It's shocking. It's really shocking. And just a point to remember that a banana, if you get a Geiger counter, a Geiger counter can't read potassium 40. So if you get a reading off a banana, that's man-made radioactive materials. Hey, folks, take care.